traders and fans of Privateer FX, back after a week's holiday, recharged and ready to go. Quiet overnight range last night, risk on after some tweets from Dopey Trump. Equities are 15 handles higher. We closed at 05. I believe we're now at 21. Not really sure what to do with that. It's just risk on tweet, risk off tweet, risk on tweet, risk off tweet. In general, we're sellers on rallies. We still have our structures on the downside. We're trading delta. Our bias is left-hand side. Just got to be nimble and professional with your delta and look both ways in this volatile but left-hand side environment. Anyway, let's take a look at crude. Got smoked on Friday. Crude is very much like Facebook. We love selling crude. It just feels great. So we do have some bias here. But again, we talked about this a couple weeks ago. $60 is a very huge psychological point here, and through 60 we think is going to bleed through 58 and take us down to the 200 day, which is 55. You could sell rallies today. Resistance is going to be up around 77, 90 area. Fresh lows today look like they're on the offing after a big red bar on Friday. So have a look at crude. The setup in cable is sideways. We had the big down day on Thursday, big up day on Friday. There was some squawking about new political parties and whatnot over the weekend. Cable hasn't reacted. And technically speaking, through 141.05 might yield something, but we're really dead set in the middle here. The death knock on this trend line is 141.50. Not too much to get excited about. I think the exciting side actually is the downside, 139.72. I don't know what the story is going to be. Maybe industrial production later in the week drives that. But 141.05 is an interesting point today. There will be some short-term momentum guys around there, so keep an eye on it. Dollar Swiss, bearish engulfing on Friday. The 200 day is 96.55. I'm cautious about selling Dollar Swiss because rates in the U.S. Should go higher today. And I think the trade here is probably everyone who does sell this. It's a bearish pattern. Confirms through the lows, has to leave their stop up here, 96.50. So, as everybody knows, I stay away from Dollar Swiss. But 96.50 looks like a break trade later in the week, or later in the month, or later in the year. This could be interesting for a nice leg. First stop 97, but you really could expect it to get up to 98.50. It's dollar Swiss. Yen crosses, very, very quiet. You can see the volatility here on the right. 0.5%. Euro yen has this 200 day here, 132.10. Should be resistance. Not much to do there. Euro sterling is inching down towards range lows here. This would be significant if we could get through 86.70. Not too many people are expecting this. Could be euro driven. Stale longs getting cut. Could be cable driven if cable drives hard to the right. But keep an eye, 86.70. And then we have Aussie Kiwi. We've been waiting on this trend line now for quite a while. Looks like we're probably going to need a touch now. Comes in at 23. Very quiet overnight, 68-96 range. We're at the highs. You could probably get this strategy started with prices through 50. But, again, just something to keep your eye on. First day back from vacation, we have a lot on the radar. We are not going to dive in. We want to get used to the price action, get a feel for things again. But I've listed a few levels to watch here, guys, and we'll be a little sharper with a little bit more specific tactical trading at the New York Open. Good luck to you guys. Talk to you soon. Ciao.